This next series will address the lives of the children of Tom and Eliza. Eliza Gillrie had three children from her first marriage to Joseph Wiley. They were George, Stuart, and Annie. Eliza and Tom Gillrie had six children. They were Albert, Amblin, Catherine, Edith, Reuben, and Elizabeth. Albert Gillrie was born in Listwell, Ontario, on September 29, 1865, 3 months after Eliza and Tom were married. Albert farmed in Kenton, Manitoba, and it was there that he met his first wife, Sophia Johnson. Together, they had three children named Russell, Vern, and Harvey. Now, in 1984, Russell gave me an account of his mother's death. He was 10 years old when she died. At the time, both he and his mother were suffering from typhoid fever, and a doctor had been called to treat them. When the doctor arrived, Russell immediately sensed there was something wrong with the doctor. The doctor appeared to be drunk. The doctor took out a dime and covered it with strychnine powder. First, he tried to get Russell to take it. Russell refused. The doctor scolded him and then turned to his mother and told her to take it. Russell pleaded with his mother not to take it. She ignored his pleas and swallowed the powder. 3 hours later, she was dead. It was 1902, and she was 32 years old at the time. 7 years after the death of his first wife, Albert met Clara Sparrow. The occasion was a horse show. Both Clara and Albert loved horses. Clara was showing ponies in a competition. She was a practical nurse who enjoyed her ponies. Albert was an excellent horseman and enjoyed racing. The two of them fell in love and were married in 1909. Albert and Clara had four children. They were Eileen, Lloyd, Bertrand, and Byron. Bertrand and Byron were twins. One night, Clara left the children with Albert while she was visiting friends. Albert had given Byron a bottle and put him to bed. Later, when he checked up on him, he found Byron had choked to death. Byron was only 2 weeks old at the time. 2 years later, tragedy struck the family again. 4.5-year-old Eileen fell through the trap door leading to the cellar. She cracked or broke her rib and ended up puncturing her spleen. The doctors misdiagnosed her condition and thought she had appendicitis and sent her to Calgary. But it was too late, and she died of blood poisoning. The eldest son, Russell, married Hallie Waite, and together they had five boys and two girls. The boys' names were George, Canton, Walter, Russell, and Larry. The little girl was Annette, but she died at birth. Later, they adopted Gail. Here is a picture of Russell and Hallie's family in 1950. The second child from Albert's first marriage was Vern, and he married Margaret Curry. They had a son, Dennis, and a daughter, Doreen. Doreen lives in Kingston, Ontario, and Dennis lives in Lethbridge, Alberta. Now, Vern farmed for 25 years in Didsbury, Alberta. Later, he became a postman living in Calgary and delivering the mail in Didsbury. For 15 of those years, Vern delivered the mail on horseback. 10 years before he retired, the horse was replaced with a car, making the hard weather and long miles easier on him. After Vern retired, he worked on a golf course in the summer and a curling rink in the winter. Vern died of a stroke in 1984 at the age of 90. Here is a rare picture of the Sparrow family with Clara standing on the left. Here is another picture of Albert and Clara Sparrow with all of their boys and spouses. Harvey Reuben Gillrie was the third child of Albert and Sophia. He was born on the 3rd of January in 1898. He was born in South Kenton, Manitoba. Harvey Gillrie married Rita Eliza Brown on the 7th of November in 1928. There is an interesting story concerning the health of Rita. Rita was always very sick and had to take a needle three times a day for her diabetes. One day, Rita went to Calgary to seek help from a doctor who had a revolutionary treatment for diabetes. She received 3 needles from this doctor, and from that point on controlled her diabetes through diet. The doctor died shortly after, and his secrets with him. When they first got married, Harvey took up farming in the small hamlet of Michichi, near Drumheller, Alberta. At that time, Harvey's father, Albert, still lived close by in Mourne, Alberta. It was in Michichi that Harvey and Rita had their 2 children. William Kenneth was born in 1929, and his brother Jack Harvey in 1923. Harvey farmed the 3/4 piece of land until it got dried out and then grasshoppered out. It was the dirty 30s, and like many farmers, the weather and the economy caused him to lose the land. He lost it all for the sake of $500. Next, Harvey and Rita moved their family onto his mother-in-law's farm. Harvey refused any government assistance and was able to take care of his family by racing horses. Both he and his father made a comfortable living through the horse racing. They could make as much as $1,000 to $1,500 in a season, and this was a considerable sum in those days. It was during this time that Harvey's children grew to love horses. When World War II broke out, Harvey moved to Calgary. In 1941, he joined the Army, and in 1942, Rita and the boys joined him in Calgary. In the Second World War, he was a sergeant stationed in Calgary with a provost company. He guarded prisoners of war. By this time, Albert had moved to Russell's farm in Didsbury to be close to his sons, Russell and Vern. After the war, Harvey moved to Didsbury following his brother's example and bought land through the VLA. Harvey had a piece of land beside his brother Russell, so the 2 families pooled their resources and worked the land. The farms were used to grow hay and oats. Wheat was not the main crop in those days. His son Ken remembered his father Harvey had a good reputation as a combine man, and his uncle Russell was a good man to run a thrashing machine. Farmers would seek out both of them during harvest season. For leisure, Harvey and Rita's family played sports and cards. Their favorite sports were curling and hockey. Rita and Harvey loved to curl. Rita was one of the top curlers in the Drumheller area throughout the 1930s. Both of them curled all their lives. Harvey and his brothers were great hockey players. Kenneth described his father as a very strict man, but a fair man. The children were taught never to speak back to their father. Kenneth recalls a time when he went to bed before finishing his chores. His father woke him up and made it very clear that was not acceptable. Ken said he only spoke once to his children about a problem. The next time he spoke with his hands. Harvey and Rita had an excellent relationship. The children could never play one against the other. The family never had much money, but they had a happy home. There was always lots to eat, and the family did a lot of things together. Natalie's mother was Rita Eliza Brown, and she can be seen here in this 1922 picture in the front row wearing the white dress. A picture of Natalie McKenzie's family also survives. Here is a picture of the McKenzies taken around 1894.